In today's video, I'm going to share with you about 9 things that did help me pass IELTS on the first attempt. So if you've written IELTS on so many occasions and you are not seeing the light at the end of the tunnel, then I believe that this video would go a long way to help you. Okay, these are the things I did that did help me pass on the first attempt. Alright, so are you interested and are you ready for me? If yes, then come with me. What I do on this channel is that I share my IELTS experience and perhaps share the process you have to go through to finally become an nurse in the UK, okay? It's all about my experience, my story, just to motivate you to take action. Alright, so without wasting much time, today, the first point I would like to start with is to draw a steady plan. You see, it is said that if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. One thing I realized about the steady plan was that initially when I started, I had no steady plan. And with this, I couldn't measure the progress of my practice, okay? What I observed was that I was only practicing the listening test, which was of much interest to me. So if you don't draw up a steady plan, you end up doing what you are interested. You end up doing the aspect of the IELTS you are interested. So if you have interest in the writing test, you end up always doing the writing test. If you have interest in the listening test, you end up always doing the listening test, and that wouldn't help. So to be able to measure the level of your progress, you should draw a steady plan. So your steady plan should be like, on Monday, which of these aspects of the IELTS are you doing? Will you be doing the listening test as well as the reading test? On Tuesday, will you be doing the writing test as well as the speaking test? So you draw a steady plan to cover up all this so that at the end of the day, even before the day counts forth, you know what you'll be doing, okay? This helps you to measure the level of your progress. Okay, the second thing you have to know if you want to pass IELTS on the first attempt is this. Be consistent. When I say consistency, is the discipline to practice each and every day. So if you have chosen the 2 month date, or if you want to practice within the space of 2 months, make sure that you are practicing IELTS each and every day until your test date is due. People who are not consistent are likely to fail the IELTS because, you see, starting IELTS is very difficult, but the very moment you continue to practice, the very moment you practice each and every day, it becomes very easy for you, okay? So try as much as possible to be consistent. I know you might be working as well as trying to figure out the IELTS. It will be very difficult, but be a little bit disciplined. With little discipline, you'll be able to conquer, you'll be able to sail through. Don't use your work schedule as a yardstick to not practice IELTS. Practicing IELTS once in a week wouldn't help. It's a matter of being consistent. So you start on Monday, you practice Tuesday, you practice till the weekends. So once you're able to practice consistently, it helps you to develop confidence for the aspect of the IELTS. So if you had difficulty with the reading test, as long as you keep on practicing every day, it becomes a little bit easier, and that boosts your confidence. So be consistent. Don't practice today and then probably practice 2 weeks after or a week after. That is not consistency. If you go outside the law of consistency, you are bound to fail IELTS on the first attempt. The third point I would like to share with you here is choosing the right test center. You see, most people may not consider this, but I believe that the test center you choose will go a long way to decide as to whether you pass on the first attempt or not. What explanation can I give to this? It is very simple. You see, there might be so many centers in your country, and as a matter of fact, I think you should choose a center that is closer to you than you ever think of. You see, whichever center you choose, you are going to write the IELTS. The policies are the same, but I'm thinking of how close you are to the place, because sometimes, you see, these centers might possibly organize some free courses just to expose you to the exam, just to make you feel at ease, just to have a feel of the environment, to ease you of any anxiety or any form of, stress that may come with the IELTS, okay? So if you are living very close to a test center, the possibility that you are always there to have a feel of these courses, to have a feel of the environment is very high. And that alone is enough to help you pass IELTS on the first attempt, because before your test date is due, you already know the environment and there's no cause for stress. The fourth point I would like to share with you to be able to pass IELTS on the first attempt is choose the right IELTS format. You see, IELTS comes in two forms. You have the IELTS Academic and the IELTS General Training. The IELTS Academic is basically for people who are in the health profession, who are in professional organizations, people who are desiring to either study in an English-speaking country, people who are desiring to work in an English-speaking country, probably in a professional organization. You deem fit to write the IELTS Academic. And the general training is for people who are in that kind of category of unprofessional organization. I mean, people who are yearning to enhance their training in an English-speaking country. Okay, so you should be able to choose the right model or format. So basically, for nurses, you have to sit for the IELTS Academic. Now, when you consider the IELTS Academic, there are two formats or there are two branches. We have the paper-based test and then the computer-based test. Most people choose the computer-based test when they have no idea or when they have that, I mean, they don't have that kind of IT skills, okay? When you are choosing the computer-based test, you should consider certain factors like, are you a fast typer? I mean, do you have much knowledge about computers? Are you able to, I mean, manipulate? I mean, you just have to consider your knowledge, your technical skills with regards to computing. Because if you have little knowledge about computer and then you go in for the computer-based test, then you should be rest assured that you are not going to make it because the rate at which you are even operating the machine would probably determine as to whether you should be faster in meeting up the time you have been set up to finish up the test or not. And for me, I knew that I had written paper-based tests all my life, so I felt I was more comfortable dealing with the paper-based test. And when I went in for that, I mean, it did help. So just go deep down within yourself. If you are that type of person who is a fast typer or probably have that kind of IT skills, then the computer-based test will be good for you. But if you have little knowledge about IT, then the paper-based test should be the best one for you. And another important thing is that if you are choosing the paper-based test, you should practice with the hard copy. Probably print out your practice sessions and then practice as such. Don't choose the paper-based test and then think of doing your practice sessions on the computer. Now, when you do that, you are like a footballer who probably trains with an orange and then goes to the field and plays a football. Now, let's look at the fifth thing I'd like to share with you to pass IELTS on the first attempt. Have certified IELTS materials. What do I mean by this? You see, you need quite a lot of practice sessions to be able to pass IELTS. And there are a bunch of practice materials out there. Some are probably genuine, others are not. So, in as much as you are gathering plenty of these practice materials, you should be able to figure out which one is standard. I mean, which one is helping you, which one meets the standard of the IELTS, I mean, by the British Council or the IDP. So, consider the kind of practice materials you are dealing with. You might be practicing all right, but may not be using the right materials, okay? So, make sure you are using the certified practice material. Once you register with the British Council or probably the IDP, depending on how much you paid, you will be given, I mean, either a quarter package or a full package of the road to IELTS, which is their practice materials, and you can start with that. But besides, there are other means of getting practice materials, and you should be careful you are getting the right materials for your practice. So now, the seed point I would like to share with you here is following and learning from the right teachers. You see, I always say that we are individual people, and as a matter of fact, we have different learning abilities. There are some people who cannot learn on their own, and they will require somebody to help. So if you are that type of person, then you need a tutor or a teacher to probably take you through the aspect of the IELTS. So if you have difficulty with the writing test, you need somebody who is good at that to help you. If you have difficulty with the speaking test, you need somebody, I mean, a teacher to help you in that aspect. If you are not good at the reading test, you need somebody to help you in that aspect. So just try to figure out, I mean, where your weaknesses are, and I mean, look out for people who can help you in that aspect. On the contrary, there are some people who can do everything on their own. They are two in one. They are the teacher as well as the student. So they learn and then teach, I mean, themselves as well. So you should be able to figure out which one are you. If you need help, go ask for help. Okay, I'll leave some contacts in the description box. Just check that out. If you need help with the IELTS, I'm all in to help. Okay, so just contact me and we can talk from there. I can share with you my experience, what I did wrong, what I did right, the strategies that did help me, and then we can move from there. Now, besides that, you can also go to YouTube. There are some good teachers out there who can also or who share good content about the IELTS. Okay, so as I said, it all boils down to where you have weaknesses on. Just go to YouTube and search. If you have weaknesses on the writing test, just search writing test, IELTS writing test, and you get content on that. But rest assured that there are so many teachers, some are not as genuine as you think. Probably you should try as much as possible to figure out those who think are sharing the same content, or those who think are giving out information that aligns to what you are looking for. Now, the seventh point I would like to share with you to pass IELTS on the first attempt is this: review your mistakes. You see, I always say that it's not about how many practice sessions you can do in a day. You can decide to do 10 practice sessions in a day. You can decide to do 20. You can decide to do 50. It doesn't matter. But what matters is your ability to review all these practice sessions and then look out for why you had an answer right and why you had an answer wrong. If you do a practice session and then you don't look back to see why you had an answer right or why you had an answer wrong, then you are not practicing, because you practice to learn from your mistakes, and you must take notice of that. So if you practice and you are not reviewing your mistakes, trust me, I'm sorry to say that you are not practicing the IELTS, because your consistency, the rate at which you practice, should probably minimize the level of mistakes you make. Okay, so if you are making 5 mistakes today, your mistakes tomorrow should be minimized. Probably should come down to about 4 or 3. That tells you that you are improving. So try to review your mistakes. After you are done with the practice session, make sure you are reviewing the mistakes. It's better to do 1 practice session a day and then review the mistakes than doing 20 and not reviewing, any of them. Now, the 8th point I would like to share with you here is choosing the right test dates. Well, in as much as people may not consider this as relevant as compared to that of choosing the test center, I think it's one of the things that is failing most IELTS test takers. You see, I always say that it's not about your interest to write IELTS, but it's about how prepared you are. Well, you see, when you are ready to write the IELTS, probably even if you want to register now, what happens here is that you must choose a specified date to sit for the exams. So if you want to prepare for a space of 2 weeks or 1 month or 3 months, ideally you should choose a date that befits this duration. Now, in choosing this date, you should be very careful, because sometimes it goes a lot to put you at the forefront of failing the IELTS. The fact that somebody has chosen 2 weeks, or the fact that you hear somebody choose 2 weeks date and pass the IELTS on the first attempt, doesn't mean that you also pass IELTS on the first attempt. I just want to let you know that we are different people and we have different learning capabilities. So the strategy I can suggest to you here is that if you want to choose a test date, just go down in yourself. Try to figure out the type of learner you are. Are you a slow learner? Are you an intermediate learner? Are you a fast learner? Okay, looking at this or considering this will help you determine how many months, how many weeks, or how many days you can prepare for the IELTS. Well, if you want to know the type of learner you are and the number of weeks or months or years that befits you for the IELTS practice, check the description box. I have a video for you. And then the last point, which is the 9th point, is having a result-oriented strategy. What do I mean by this? You see, I always say that if your test date is getting closer and you haven't had any concrete strategy, then you should be rest assured that you are only going on the field just to try. The possibility of you failing IELTS is very high. Because pass IELTS on the first attempt, you should have a strategy. Not just any strategy, result-oriented strategy. Strategy you have practiced over and over and over with and realizes that anytime you use that strategy, it's like you get the right, results, you get the right mark. And this strategy should be able to help you work within the space or the time you have been given. So if it's a reading test, you should be able to work as fast as possible within the 1 hour or the 60 minutes time you have been given. If it's a writing test, you should be able to work your way around it. Strategy should help you work your way around it to finish up on time. Okay, so if your strategy is not allowing you, or it's not giving you the opportunity to basically look at all this, then you don't have a concrete strategy. You don't have a result-oriented strategy. And I can assure you that you won't pass IELTS on the first attempt. I'm sorry about that. So if you want to know the strategy that did help me attain the results I needed or the band score I needed in the reading test, check the description box. Thank you very much. I hope this video has been very helpful. If it has, do subscribe to my YouTube channel for more. And also make sure that you are liking this video, sharing, and then commenting. So if you have any questions, don't hesitate to leave it in the comment box. And I promise I'll come over and then give an answer to that. Okay. Thank you very much. Hope to see you in my next video. Bye.